afternoon, students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine. You know, dear children, today I am teaching you English and I am your English teacher. Last chapter, that is lesson number one, that what you have done in the lockdown period? Yes, you have learned, that is lesson number one, the types of sentences. How many types of sentences are there? Yes, you are correct. That is the four types of sentences. And the second lesson is that our lesson is the lesson number two in our textbook is the subject and predicate. So we are learning here what is mean by subject and what is mean by predicate, and we are going to be taking the few examples on this chapter. So here we see, as you have learned the English, that is the sentences, what is the sentence? The sentence is divided into two parts. That is two parts, which are the first one is subject and it's the other one is a predicate. In the sentence, as again I am saying, sentence always carries the subject and the predicate. What is the definition of sentence? Definition of sentence is? Yes. The group of words that gives a complete meaning is called a sentence. For example, the children are playing on the ground, giving the complete meaning, the group of words. So this sentence is divided into subject and predicate. Now here we are learning what is meant by subject. What is the definition of subject then? The subject, the part of the sentence, in one sentence, that is a part of the sentence that tells us about who or what. The sentence is same. In the sentence, it is telling about who or what the sentence is saying is called the subject. In one sentence. So, for example, if we see that here, Nina wants a pink dress. What is the definition? Who or what the sentence is saying? What the sentence is saying? Sentence is saying that Nina wants a pink dress. So that Nina, who and what the sentence is saying? About what? About who? About what? About Nina. Nina wants a pink dress. So here in this first sentence, example of this sentence is Nina is a subject. The second thing is, second example is, your parents and teachers are your well-wishers. Are your well-wishers. What is the definition? Again you come to the definition. Telling or the sentence that tells us about who or what. What it is telling? Telling about your parents. Your parents and teachers are your well-wishers. So, this your parents and teachers are the subject. And the third one is, third example is, Radhika wants to become an astronaut. Who wants to become an astronaut? Telling about what? Or telling about what? She, the Radhika, wants the word to become an astronaut. So here in this sentence, Radhika is a subject. In short, dear children, the subject is a naming word, name of place, thing, or animal. This is called a subject. Now, after the subject, we are going to learn the predicate. What is the predicate? So this predicate gives us the rest part of the subject. I think so you might have understood this. What is the subject? Subject tells about the who. Sentence telling about the who and what. Now we are going to learn is the predicate. So the second is predicate. shows he is a predicate. Now the third example. Radhika wants to become an astronaut. Subject is Radhika. Telling about the predicate, more about the noun. What we are telling about the Radhika? About the subject? Yes, wants to become an astronaut. So the remaining part of that subject, leaving the subject aside, the remaining part is a sentence predicate. So this is a predicate. See here, children, you might have noticed we, in the parts of sentences, part of speech, we have learned the 8 parts of speech: noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjectives, and all. So, here, what is the definition of verb? The definition of verb is, yes, you are correct, action verb. Action word. Yes, I am playing. What action I am doing? Playing is a verb. The same helping verbs are there. Is and are. It is called the helping verbs. So here in the predicate, dear children, you have to keep in mind how to find out the predicate. See, subject is also very easy. And suppose if you are very difficult things of speech, the in the sentence there is always verb. And that verb, without verb, that sentence is incomplete. So from the verb, whichever part is left over, you know, from the verb, see, this is a verb. Helping verb. This is a verb, main verb, you know. Main verb. Here is also what wants main verb. This is also verb. Main verb. Means verb. Predicate contains verb in that. Predicate contains verb in that. See, this is a verb. From where the verb starts, that from that part to the next part is a predicate. Mostly for the 6th standard, you can, in short, you can think over this. The always in the subject part, only the naming words. It may be one word or the group of words. See here, subject may be one word. Nina, you are the Radhika. Subject may be 1, 2, 3, 4 words, 5 words, 6 words. But in the predicate part, comes always from the verb. Verb comes under the predicate. This is, you know, we have learned this. So this here we have completed the subject and the predicate part. What we have learned? We have learned the sentence set. We know the recapitulation. You have learned the last lesson. You have learned the sentences, and the sentence only divided into 2 parts, that is subject and the predicate. Then subject. What is the subject? Subject, the part of the sentence. Sentence is about who or what the sentence is saying. And the examples that we are saying that Nina wants to interest your readings and teachers of the subject. And the second part is predicate, the part of the sentence that tells us more about the subject called the predicate. The examples are here. I hope, children, you understood. So, in your notebook, lesson number 2 of the grammar notebook, you can open that and you can solve those examples.